So when Derek comes to you and asks you about making a documentary about yourself, how did you feel about that? Were you reticent at all?
Well, I mean, I felt honored that someone thinks I could pull off a documentary about my life, but the success of the book showed me that a lot more people were interested in my story than I thought might be. So when Derek approached me, I thought that was the time to do it. And he knew the right things to say and the right avenues, and the fact that he was able to premiere it here was huge for me, because I've always loved this festival and haven't been here in a while, so it was fun to come back with the documentary.
Yeah, horror has such a loyal following, doesn't it, really? And to bring it to the home of horror is the ideal location.
Exactly, and because it's such a big event, I thought, you know, a lot of press and stuff and people that saw the movie are going to talk about it, so I'm very happy about that.
And with regards to horror, people sort of may dismiss horror, but when you actually, as somebody that's worked in it so closely over the years, there is so much subtext and social commentary, isn't there, within horror films?
Of course there is. People that don't know horror are the ones that are first to judge it and dismiss it. And in fact, even a lot of people, when they hear about this documentary, are hesitant to watch it, because they say, well, I don't like horror movies, so I don't want to watch that. And it's like very frustrating, because it's a documentary about my life, not about horror films. Part of it talks about that, because that's part of my life, but it certainly isn't a documentary on horror films. It's someone's life story, and I wish people would get past that.
And because for somebody that's had such a lengthy career, starting as a stuntman, have you seen how the industry has evolved over the years with regards to stunts?
Yeah, I mean, stunts are far more refined now. The stunt business is different than it was 40 years ago when I started. But I still love keeping my hand in it. I love coordinating stunts and still, you know, I just did an episode of a TV show last month. A show called The Night Shift. I'm not sure if you have it, but and I played a police officer that gets killed, so I had to hit the ground again, and it was like, haven't done that in a little while, so it was fun to do it again.
I would imagine that this story is a very human story.
It is. It's a human interest story more than it is a horror story, and I feel it's really important for people to see it, whether they love horror films or not. It's about the bullying, the burn, and so many other elements in his life.
How did you first build up a relationship with Kane? So in order for him to trust you, to be able to open up and feel that he was in a safe environment to talk?
Yeah, well, building up the relationship with Kane honestly was easy, because he was open to the idea of it. So we had a few meetings with him before and just talked, like had long lunches, long dinners, and we're able to build, like, okay, we like each other, we have the same vision in mind. And then we kind of got down to business, and he shared things on the first day, in the first 20 minutes, like I was a best friend, and now we're good friends because of the movie, and I really wouldn't have it any other way.
Quite often when you make these kind of documentaries, you often find there's a new thread that you never knew before. Did you find that with this film as well?
Yeah, with the fact that we shot it over 2 full years, things that came up and moved around that really we didn't know at the beginning, but I feel like focusing on those human interest elements, and especially with a lot of the stuff we shot in Hawaii, which was our second shoot, allowed us to focus on the most intriguing elements so that people would really love this movie. And I feel it's a great place.
And you've got some great contributors. Was it easy to secure interviews with them?
Strangely enough, it was really easy to get the interviews with all of his colleagues, because they love Kane so much and they respect him. So it was just a matter of giving him a phone call and bang, we're done, you know? Like, they say yes, and we're good to go. So it was impressively easy, and it speaks to Kane as a person.
Tell us what it was about Kane that you wanted to make a documentary about him.
Sure, so everyone knows Kane as Victor Crowley and as Jason Voorhees, and he's become this iconic character. But what drew me to the story in particular, and our director, Derek Herbert, was Kane's human interest story, a story of survivorship, something that I think broad audience can understand and identify with, and I think that people are starting to do that.
Was it an easy task to get Kane involved in the project? Because most actors are pretty reticent.
Well, fortunately, Kane had already written the book, right? So he had already told part of his story, but he had never told it in person in a way that people would be able to see and really and consume a little easier. So Kane's very easy to work with. I think that comes across in the documentary. I think anyone that's worked with him knows that. But with such a sensitive topic, it was difficult at times. And I think what ultimately came down to is his trust in our ability to tell his story in a way that was meaningful to him. And I'm just very glad that he liked how it turned out.
And your role as a producer, do you as well go and source archive material to help sort of flesh the documentary out?
Yeah, so you know, really my job was to figure out, you know, who needed to be in this film, how could we best get them in there, and really the logistics of all of it. Because when you're talking to, you know, Cassandra Peterson, Bruce Campbell, Robert Englund, I mean, these people are very, very busy. Fortunately, all of them were very willing to participate in this. You know, Kane is great friends with all of them, and it speaks a lot about his personality that these people were willing to take time to do something like that.